Hey guys, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got a good one for you today. A lot of players ask whether learning scales is a good way to memorize the guitar neck. Now, if you've been wondering about this, then I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. And this method is really foolproof, simple way to identify scale layouts, notes on the neck, and patterns that you'll use all the time for creating anything from guitar solos to building chords across the whole neck of the guitar. Now, when thinking about the guitar fingerboard, there are three areas that guitar teachers generally use. They're the low neck region, the middle neck region, and the upper neck region. And very often, students learn scales locked into each independent area. It's an okay approach. It does work to a certain level, but it produces a compartmentalized way of learning. Now, in this lesson, we're going to approach things differently. We're going to apply a two-string method for using major and minor pentatonic scales, and that's going to get us across the whole neck. So let's get started with the first two-string breakdown right now. Our first two-string breakdown exercise will focus on playing the G minor pentatonic. So let's get started. All right, I have three exercises that I want to go over with you. The first one is between strings 6 and 5. It goes like this. Okay, one more time. All right, the next exercise goes between strings 4 and 3. It goes like this. Here it is once more. All right, and the last one is on the top two strings, strings 2 and 1. Time. All right, so you want to practice those and memorize them, turn a metronome on, get as good as you can at them. We'll talk a little bit more about some more in-depth study as the lesson proceeds. Coming up next, I've got more of this method to go over with you. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer I'm running for my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here. And if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Our next two-string exercise will focus on playing the G major pentatonic. So our shift will take us now over to the major tonality. Let's zoom in on the neck and run through these shapes right now. All right, now we're going to look at the G major pentatonic. We're going to be working initially with our first group of three exercises, studying the strings of 6 and 5. So here's the 6th and 5th strings layout for G major pentatonic. Here it is again. All right, now the next exercise is going to be focused on strings 4 and 3, and it goes like this. Okay, once more. All right, our last exercise is on the top two strings, strings 2 and 1, and it goes like this. Again. All right, so what you're probably starting to notice as you're practicing these shapes is that when you're traveling along this particular grouping of strings, you know, whether it's 6 and 5, 4 and 3, or 2 and 1, you're encountering pretty much all the same shapes. You know, they're just ripping across the neck in a different order and sequence, you know. And we're going to talk about that much more in the Patreon video. And also, as this lesson continues, I've got a couple of things I want to go over with you coming up next on this too, because it's so important to see the layouts of these and understand how they're moving around. Now, in the Patreon video, we're going to get pretty deep because we're going to be crossing between strings and doing some different work with these that we're not going to attend to in the YouTube video here. But as things move forward, the first tip or advice idea that I have for you is to just watch the geometrical positioning and the shape of each box as we're traveling in this lateral way. So once you do that and you're capable of that, it's going to be really easy to start playing these things a lot faster and smoother. But let's get on to my final topic that I have for you, because it's going to tie a lot of these ideas together. In my final example, I wanted to spend a few minutes focusing on the additional benefits that can come out of doing these two-string pentatonic workouts, specifically with regard to learning the notes on the neck. So let's break this one down. So far, we've done a really good job of getting these two-string layouts together, but the next thing I want to cover is the naming of the notes. That's really important, and also the geometrical patterning and kind of like box shapes that you can learn about. So first of all, you know, when you pick a key, we're going to use, for our example here, we're going to use G minor pentatonic. We're going to take a G root here. We're also going to see the other G roots on the neck. You know, make sure you know where those are in the two-string layout. And then once you have that, start organizing the notes of the scale around the G roots. You got an F in behind there. There's a B flat above with a C, and then a D. There's a B flat over here. We also have around this G up here, we've got the F and the C and the D. So, you know, there's lots of ways to map the neck along the span, you know, G and B flat there, D and F below it, and then you're kind of right back at the beginning again where you started from. So it's very quick and easy to get the notes down. You'll see them, you know, very easily because it's just pentatonic. It's 5-tone scale layouts. You do major, you do minor, you're going to have a really good comprehension of how everything's laid out, and you'll start being able to understand the notes that are missing in between very easily as well. Now, another thing that's important too is to, you know, sort of bracket off notes into groupings that fit under our fingers really nicely. And, you know, for instance, if we look at the G, B flat, C, and D notes that are located off of the third position here, they, you know, they form a box over there. And then, you know, moving forward, we've got the B flat, C, D, and F for another box shape up here. Then above that, another box shape, C, D, F, G. And you can just keep going along the neck, formulate the box shapes, understand how all the geometrical patterning works, but more specifically, get to know the note names. And we just did minor here, but, you know, you also would want to do, you know, G major as well. And then go through all the other keys too, you know, do A minor and A major, and then do F minor and F major, and, you know, just keep going, go through all the key signatures. It's going to get you to understand and learn the notes on the neck so well. Plus, you're going to have so much more, you know, comprehension and flexibility with the pentatonic scales from playing them so laterally as well. So it's a fantastic workout system, and it's going to get you to know your neck like the back of your hand. It's just great work. Guys, there is a Patreon video for this lesson, and you're not going to want to miss it, because in this Patreon video, I'm going to be going and filling in some of the details behind this two-string method. We're going to go through details that we didn't cover here in the YouTube video. Plus, I also have a two-string soloing jam track that we're going to study. I'll teach you how to play it. We'll go through the chord changes, and I'm going to talk about applying these two-string ideas over that jam track. Also, keep in mind that if you are a Patreon member, you always get a very detailed PDF handout of the entire lesson, everything we cover on YouTube, and then of course everything we're going to do on Patreon. Along with that, you always get a jam track along with the bonus video. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month member today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up. It really helps with the YouTube algorithms. Also remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.